mighty name of Jesus. And every destiny of the house of worship and healing, wherever it is, we call it to appear. We command it to appear. We command it to appear. We command it to come forth in the mighty name of Jesus. Every talent that is hidden, every talent that is dead, we command it to come back to life. We command it to function again in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Praise be to God. And I believe we have this others in the house.
presence. The mighty God. Hallelujah. Hey. Jesus is coming again.
Amen.
Maranatha.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hey. Thank God. We're in the right place. The right time. Updates. Jesus is coming again.
Amen.
That's the first one. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah. We have to keep reminding ourselves that, because the Bible says those who have this hope, they keep purifying themselves. Because the one who has called us is pure, is holy. Amen. Kwa hivyo, Yesu anarudi tena. Amen. Katika yote tunafanya, tujue ya kwamba Yesu anakuja na tujiandae, kwa sababu mapenzi yake ni atupate tukiwa tayari. Na kwa sababu hiyo, hapa tunaendelea kujiandaa kama kanisa kwa ajili ya kumtumikia Mungu na pia kungojea kurudi kwa Yesu. Ibada zetu, the hours of service, ibada ya kwanza ni saa moja mpaka saa tatu, 7 to 9 a.m. worker service. Well, if you want to be prepared so that you can serve God effectively, please make a point of attending the service from 7 to 9 a.m. every Sunday. See all our chosen few. This service is for everyone who wants to serve the Lord, who wishes to serve the Lord. Well, if you karibuni sana, then we have our services. The main service, like we are in now, it starts by 9 a.m. afternoon. Family service. Why, if you, everyone, make a point of coming early so that by 9 you are in for the family service every Sunday. And the Lord will bless you. 12 to 1:30, we have other meetings, departmental meetings. Any department wishing to meet, they can meet from 12 to 1:30. Other meetings in the church. Midweek prayer meetings. There is the prayers at the word from Monday to Friday, every evening, from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. This house is open and prayers are going on. Kwa hivyo tumekaribishwa sote kwa ajili ya mikutano ya maombi na neno la Mungu. Kwa hivyo kila siku kuanzia Jumatatu mpaka Ijumaa, isipokuwa ile Ijumaa tuko na kesha, basi tunakutana hapa kwa ajili ya maombi ya jioni kuanzia 6 mpaka 7:30. Na hiyo maombi ni ya kila mtu, kwa hivyo karibuni sana. Now this coming Friday, being the first Friday of the month of November, we are going to have a great kesha here. We are going to command the month of November. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, we cannot allow things just to happen. We cannot just sit to see things happen. Now, it's like we don't have a say. It's like we can't, you know, do anything about them. God has given us an opportunity as a church. So this Friday we are coming here to command the month of November. Ni nini unataka katika mwezi wa November? What do you want? What do you want God to do for you, for your family, for this church, for the nation? Stop complaining. Ya kwamba there is corruption. Stop complaining. Ya kwamba marriages are breaking. Come and command the marriages to stand. Come and command the nation to walk in righteousness. You cannot sit and complain and murmur and die there. Usikuwa kama wale wenye ukoma. Walisema ya kwamba tukiendelea kukaa hapa bila shaka tutakufa. And let me tell you, if you choose to stay where you are, the way the nation is, let me not say, lakini we are supposed to come and command. Amen.
Amen.
Command the righteousness to lead in our country. Amen.
Amen.
By your Friday, welcome for the kesha. It shall be 4th of November. Kwa hivyo karibuni sana. purpose to attend and make sure you invite somebody. Invite your neighbor, invite your friend, your workmate, anybody. Bring somebody in the kesha and God will bless you. Thank you for all those who have committed themselves to support our pastor in the project he has. He has a new car and we thank God for it. Thank you for those who pledged to support him, to pay the balance so that he can happily own the car he has. Amen.
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 Thank you so much. Now, we want to remind you, please, honor your pledge. Amen. Kile ambacho ulisema uta support mchungaji nayo, he is our pastor, this is our father. We love him so much. Amen. Na kwa sababu Mungu alituconvict, tuka pledge, tuka ahindi, kutoa kitu kusimama na mtumishi wake, jameni ni every month. Kwa wale ambao wanangojea salary, wengine labda simeingia, wengine simeingia this week, please, as you budget for your salary, your income, remember to honor the pledge. There is also the pledge of cameras. You know, kulifanya pledge ya camera. And some of us, we thank God we have honored, and those who we have not honored yet, please make sure umetimisa ahadi yako ya kulipa hiyo fedha. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. Ukiwa mwenzako mwambie, ni vyema kutimisa nadhiri. Kuondoa nadhiri. In fact, it is kuondoa nadhiri. Aha. Uondoe nadhiri ile ambayo uliweka. And God will bless you in the process of doing it. Thank you so much. Now, we are going to have also another kesha, which will be taking place at the Luther Deliverance Church. But this is for daughters of faith. Now, daughters of faith, you have to decide, because it is good you attend that kesha, it is yours, but please, as you plan about it, mnaweza gawana katikati. Nusu ikae home, nusu iende kule kwingine. Amen?
Amen.
Kwa hivyo, please, ma'am, see that issue and make sure that we don't, tusiwe men peke yetu hapa, unajua, sio mbaya, kwa sababu ni vyema, lakini tungeomba wandada tabadhali wengine mwe pamoja nasi siku hiyo, hata mnapopanga kuhudhuria hiyo kesha ambayo itakuwa kanisa la Ukombozi la Leruta. Kwa hayo mengi na machache, Bwana Mungu awabariki. Now we want to stand together even as we bring the man of God, our pastor, our dad, to come and bring the word of God. Let's stand together. Let's get prepared, even as we prepare our heart to receive from the Lord, because I believe the Lord has a word for each one of us. Let's put our hearts together as we welcome the Son of God, Pastor Nicole, his interpreter, John Robbie.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah. tunasimama kwenye uwepo wako Mungu wetu.
We honor your grace.
Tunaheshimu neema yako.
For the Bible says,
Maana Biblia inasema,
the law was given by Moses.
Sheria ilipeanwa na Musa.
But grace came through Jesus Christ.
Lakini neema ilikuja kupitia Yesu Kristo.
Your grace come upon us this morning.
Wacha neema yako ije juu yetu asubuhi ya leo.
The grace to overcome.
Neema ya kushinda.
The grace to emerge victorious in the battles of life.
Neema ya kuibuka washindi katika vita vya maisha.
The grace of good health.
Neema ya afya nzuri.
The grace of salvation.
Neema ya wokovu.
The grace that makes us to have our inheritance.
Neema ambayo inasababisha tuweze kupokea urithi wetu.
The grace that makes us know that we know that we know that we are the sons of God.
Neema ambayo inasababisha tujue kwamba tunajua kwamba sisi ni wana.
The grace to live.
Neema ya kuishi.
And to enjoy every single day of our life.
Na kufurahia kila siku ya maisha yetu.
Knowing that we have a God who can never be compared to any other.
Tukijua kwamba tunaye Mungu hawezi kulinganishwa na kingine chochote.
The God who fights our battles.
Mungu anayepigana vita vyetu.
The God who is eternal.
Mungu ambaye ni milele.
The God who is a blesser.
Mungu ambaye ni kubariki.
The generation of God.
Mungu wa kizazi.
The creator of heaven and earth.
Mungu wa mbingu na nchi.
In you we trust.
Ndani yake tutumaini.
In you we move.
Ndani yako tutembea.
In you we have everything.
Ndani yako tuna kila kitu.
Away from you we have nothing.
Kando na wewe hatuna chochote.
We will not sing any other song.
Hatutaimba wimbo mwingine.
We will never worship another God.
Hatutaabudu Mungu mwingine.
Our life is totally sold out to you.
Maisha yetu tumeyasalimisha yote kwako.
You are our refuge.
Wewe ndiye kimbilio letu.
You are the proclamation of our faith.
Wewe ndiye ungama la imani yetu.
To you and from you we came.
Kutoka kwako na kwako tulitoka.
And to you shall we return.
Na kwako tutarejea.
We honor you.
Tunakuheshimu.
We reference you.
Tunakuadhimisha.
We humble before you.
Tunanyenyekea mbele zako.
We bring down our crowns.
Tunashusha taji zetu.
To say we have nothing to hold on to.
Kusema ya kwamba hakuna chochote cha kushikilia.
Only you can we hold on to.
Ila wewe tu ndiye tunaweza shikilia.
We honor you, Lord.
Tunakuheshimu Bwana.
Let's praise the Lord again.
Pokea sifa na shukrani.
And be glorified in this service.
Na utukuzwe katika ibada hii.
Cause everyone to partake of your blessing.
Sababisha kila mmoja wetu aweze kushika baraka zako.
For you have said clearly in your word.
Maana umesema wazi kutoka neno lako.
They that are thirsty.
Wale walio na kiu.
Come to me and drink.
Njooni kwangu na mnywe.
Come and drink without money.
Njooni mnywe bila pesa.
Because you have already done it all for us.
Maana tayari ushatenda yote kwa ajili yetu.
We give you praise.
Tunakupa sifa.
And we give you thanksgiving.
Tunakupa shukrani.
Receive thanksgiving from our hearts.
Pokea shukrani za mioyo yetu.
Because we ask this in Jesus' name.
Maana tunaomba haya katika jina la Yesu.
Let every child of God shout amen.
Amen.
Now, you know, if we ask in another name, we will get nothing.
Tukiuliza katika jina lingine hatutapata chochote.
Because Jesus said, only if you ask in my name.
Manake Yesu alisema ya kwamba ikiwa mtauliza katika jina langu.
Anything from the Father you ask in my
name. Chochote kutoka kwa Baba yangu mtakachouliza katika jina langu.
You will receive it.
Utakipokea.
That is why when I said, because we have asked in the name of Jesus, you should say amen. If I have asked in any other name, you should not say amen. Because you will not listen. But if we have asked in the name of Jesus Christ, can somebody shout amen?
Amen!
Because we have asked in the name of Jesus, somebody shout amen!
Amen!
And worship the Lord with a clap of the blessed. It is written in the book of Luke chapter 19. I want to give you two prayer points that we are done.
Ningependa kukupa dokezo mbili za maombi tumalizie.
In the book of Luke chapter 19.
Katika Luka 19.
It is written.
Imeandikwa.
Where is this? It shall be said, my house shall be called a house of prayer for all the people. Okay, where is this? Think, verse number 20 something. Where is it? Luke chapter 19. Verse number, I go to get it.
Have you got it ahead of me? Luke chapter 19. Is that? I have it. It shall be said, my house shall be called the house of prayer. You got it? Manasseh, where are you? Manasseh is not on this. Alright. Have you got it? Yeah. My house. Luke chapter 19, verse 46. 45. It says, then he entered the temple area and began driving out those who were selling. Verse 46. It is written, he said to them, my house will be the house of prayer, but you have made it into a den of robbers. My house shall be called the house of prayer. My house shall be called the house of
prayer.
Okay. Now give me this scripture very fast. Romans 12:21. Romans 12:21, very fast, please. Romans 12:21. Everyone read with me. 1, 2, 3. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. Again, please. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. 1 John 4:4. Hadassah. Everybody, 1 John 4:4. Everybody read with me, 1, 2, 3. You dear children are from God and have overcome them because the one who is in you is greater than the one who is in the world. Tell somebody, speak to somebody now. Tell them you need to overcome.
You need to overcome
them.
Them.
Because the one who is in you,
the one who is
greater,
is greater
than him,
than him
who is in them,
who is in them.
In Jesus' name. 1 John 5:5. I like those scriptures which are the end that because they are easy to memorize. 1, 2, 3, everybody. 1, 2, 3. Who is this that overcomes the world?
Only he who believes that Jesus is the Son of God.
How many believe that Jesus is the Son of God?
Yes.
But just by that, you already are an overcomer.
Amen.
I declare you an overcomer in Jesus.
Amen. My name.
What does it mean to overcome? To overcome is to go over.
Yes.
It's like somebody who is drowning in water and suddenly you fight in the water and you come out.
Amen.
And life is like that.
Now,
things we are fighting. But I prophesy to you,
yes,
let the spirit of an overcomer arise in you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Right now, open your mouth and I want you to pray. Pray that God will cause you to overcome. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Release the spirit. Tap the spirit of an overcomer. In the name of the Lord Jesus. We declare a spirit of overcoming. The spirit of overcoming. The spirit of an overcomer. Let the spirit of an overcomer come upon us. Come upon us. Come upon me. Let the spirit of an overcomer come upon me. Come upon my life. Let the spirit of overcoming come upon my life. Come upon my life. Let the spirit of an overcomer come upon my life. people high five. Tell them, I am an overcomer.
I am an overcomer.
Tell somebody, you are an overcomer.
You are an overcomer.
Tell somebody, you are a winner.
You are a winner.
Tell somebody, you have overcome.
You are
the evil one.
The evil one.
For greater is he in you.
Kanisani mwa askofu wetu, askofu Bishop Kanyaru.
And we had a great week.
Na tulikuwa na wiki ya ajabu.
And a great men conference from all over Murang'a region and central Kenya.
Kulikuwa na kongamano la wanaume Murang'a region na central Kenya.
And all the things we did, they were great.
Na mambo yote tuliyotenda pale yalikuwa makubwa.
And I'm happy to see you again.
Nimefurahia kuona tena.
Please greet your neighbor on my behalf. Tell them, receive greetings of Pastor
Gimpa.
Tell them you are important. Tell them it's good. Tell them I'm happy you are my neighbor. Tell them you are smart. Tell them you are, I mean it, you are smart. Okay, if you don't believe they are smart, say, tell them, Pastor says you are smart. And I believe it. But I am smarter than you. Tell them I'm smarter than you. Bwana asifiwe. Amen. Isn't it good to be smart in the house of God?
Yes.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Bwana asifiwe.
I am also smart.
Yeah.
If you don't think I'm smart,
kama ufikiri mchungaji ameng'ara,
let me show you I am smart. I am really smart.
Ameng'aruka.
Amen. Right from the foot.